Hello there, welcome to this video. Let's see how to build and design 3D projects with ArchiCAD 19. Leave us comments to improve our next guides in the future. ArchiCAD offers you many tools to create 3D projects, especially architectural and house designs. All 3D tools are included inside Design section in the toolbox, and we will see how to use the most important ones, but mind that you may need practice and experience if you want to create a very good professional design. If you want to download this simple house design to take as example, download it from the video description. For example, if you want to trace a wall, click on the wall tool and click and drag on your project as you do with the line tool. The wall drawn seems completely flat, like a 2D rectangle, since, by default, ArchiCAD shows you projects always from a top view, called the ground floor. This is useful for 2D projects, but maybe not for 3D projects with extrusion. There are three main 3D views available in ArchiCAD: the elevation views, the floor views, and the 3D visualization. The elevations are blue line segments that lay on your project while using any floor view, like the ground floor. These are used to check your project from each of their point of view in the same direction indicated by their arrows. To open an elevation view, simply right-click on it and go to Open Elevation. By default, you have just four elevations: north, south, east, and west. But you can also create new points of view by creating other elevations. To do this, simply select an elevation and use Ctrl and C to copy it and Ctrl and V to paste it elsewhere. Then, using the arrow tool and the editing tools, move and rotate it to create the right point of view. The elevation view takes not just the point of view pointed by its arrow, but also the elevation segment length. For example, if the elevation segment is too short, you may not be able to see the whole object in such view, so mind to take it as long as needed. The elevation view shows different fixed height levels, called floors or stories. These are blue annotations that fix the height of each floor view, such as the ground floor, the first floor, and so on. The Navigator palette on the right lists all the views available in the project. Below Stories, you find all the floors available, elevations, all the points of view of each elevation segment. Double-click on a view to open it. Right-click to rename. Stories do not fix the elevation level only, but also the height where an object base must lay. If an object stays on the floor story and the story height changes, the object follows. If you want to create a new story, simply right-click on a story and then go to Create a New Story. Decide name and height from the ground. To adjust the height later, simply right-click on a story and then go to Story Settings. The third view is the 3D visualization. To enable this, simply go to Window and then to 3D Window. Use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out. To move, click on the pen tool below and click and drag. If you press O key, you enable the orbit command to rotate and check in 3D. Use escape key to exit. For a more realistic 3D view, use the explode command below and follow the instructions in the following dialog box. Let's see how to create a 3D project. For this, you can choose the view you like most. There are three main different tools to draw a 3D project: the architecture tools, the morph tool, and the mesh tool. The first group of tools collects all house and building templates ready to use, all listed in the toolbox, from up to down. Each of these templates can be also personalized through the info box and the default settings options above. To draw walls, enable the wall tool and click and drag to fix a side. The object base is placed on the ground floor by default, as you can see from the blue grid. You can link this grid to different stories by clicking on its symbol. The door tool places doors on walls. Select it and adjust the dimensions and the height from the wall base through the info box, or click and drag the purple points to open or close the door. The window tool works exactly the same, placing windows on the wall. The column tool creates a column, while the roof tool creates roofs. Just click and drag as you do with a rectangle. With the stair tool, you can paste stairs ready to be used. There are also other two advanced tools, the Morph and the Mesh tool. The Morph tool is used to create, in a 3D environment, 2D lines and planes, also called surfaces. Differently from the 2D tools in the document section that never appear in the 3D view, the morphs are 2D objects that can have 3D materials and can be drawn and seen in a 3D environment. While drawing in a 3D environment, you have three main directions: the X and Y axis, used for length and width, and the Z axis, used for the height. In a story view, just the X and the Y axis are available. You will follow such main directions if the axes are highlighted in yellow. Also in this case, ArchiCAD helps you with some key points already seen for 2D projects like the vertices, medians and points on paths. In 3D, you have one additional key point, a rhombus with a cross on the center that indicates a point taken on a 3D face. Plus, you can hover on paths to help yourself with guides and use your keyboard to type precise values. However, in a 3D environment, the editing tools do change. If you click on a node or vertex, you can drag, rotate, mirror, multiply, move the node, offset, and fillet chamfer as seen in 2D. Just the icons change. Plus, there is also the tube tool that creates a 3D conductor taking a section the plane where you start from. To stop drawing, click on the latest point fixed when the pointer becomes a black pencil. Box stretch is used to stretch a 3D object by moving its box nodes. Click on the pencil instead to add other planes and surfaces. If you click on a path, you find the same editing tools already seen. If you click on a face, you can use budge to deform a face, or push-pull to add extrusion to a face or a surface. Plus, use fillet chamfer corners to apply the 3D fillet and chamfer. All these editing tools can be applied on a 3D view only. If you use 2D views, like elevations or stories, you can use the editing tools seen in 2D, apart from the Elevate tool. To delete 3D objects, just right-click on these. Also, in the standard bar, you can use the same advanced tools seen for 2D projects. For example, the Split tool cuts a 3D object in two parts by using a red plane. If you have a ready-made template you want to personalize, convert it to Morph, right-clicking on it and going to Convert Selection to Morph. If you want to create a completely personalized 3D object from scratch instead, you need to use the Mesh tool. With this, you create a personalized object starting from a simple 3D box. Then, by clicking on the nodes, you can use Add and Subtract from Polygon to add new nodes, and by using the editing tools seen on nodes and paths, you can shape your object as you like. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel to learn more.